We come to you live from Bulldog Field at the Fitchburg-Westminster line as FATV presents coverage of Monty Tech football. It's been a long time since we've been able to come down here to Bulldog Field, but we picked a great time to come out as it's homecoming week here at Monty Tech as the host Bulldogs take on the Eagles of Worcester Tech. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I'm Daniel Bolak. Happy to have you along with us here today. John Gugerty's on assignment. We'll have him back next week for Fitchburg and Neshoba from Crocker Field. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention Panthers eat wolves meat. Get that out of the way. But Monty Tech and Worcester Tech set to do football battle week six of the 2021 MIAA football season. Monty Tech coming into this game with a record of 1 win and 4 losses in their first season in Division 5 in the MIAA matrix. Worcester Tech also in Division 5. They come into this game with a record of 4-1. Both teams struggled a little bit in the fall 2 season. Monty Tech was 0-4. Worcester Tech was 1-4. But the Eagles have had the run of play going for them right now. They've been in pretty much every game. And I know I talked with Coach Derek Robbins before the game. He's pretty satisfied with how competitive his side has been. You know, every game's been pretty competitive. 32-6 win over Worcester rival Burncoat. 27-8 win over Ayr Shirley. That's the Panthers' only loss of the season thus far. 43-8 win over Bartlett. Blackstone Valley Tech was a bit of a struggle. Well, it was close right to the end. It was only the Beavers getting a late touchdown that made it a 21-7 game. And then last week against Assabet, a nail-biter, a blocked kick was the difference in that one. A 13-12 victory for the Eagles over the Aztecs to get them to 4-1 on the season. For Monty Tech, they opened with a 21-6 loss against Murdoch. Then they got their first and lone win of the season on September the 17th. 24-14 victory over Gardner. 28-6 they fell to Narragansett, 33-6 they fell to Baypath, and then last week Blackstone Valley Tech, possibly, you know, consistently year in and year out one of the most dominant teams in Central Mass, let alone the trade schools. They can compete with the regular schools just as much as anybody else. They were a state champion a couple of years ago as well, and the Beavers showed their mettle last week here at Bulldog Field. 49-0 Blackstone Valley Tech won that game over Monty Tech, sending the Bulldogs to 1-4. We have a look at the Monty Tech roster. You can see it's a relatively young roster, 62 players, but only 8 seniors, 15 juniors, 19 sophomores, 20 freshmen. I was talking with some of the players before the game. Even they seemed a bit surprised at how many underclassmen they have. It is a really young team. They are aware of that, but they come out to fight every week. We'll be expecting Pat Hill to be the starting quarterback for the Bulldogs, and he's just a sophomore himself. You look at some of these starters for Monty Tech. You look at Brady Burpee. He's a sophomore. Mason Burke, he's a senior, but one of those lone upperclassmen, just one of the few in there that tries to make contributions, because with the starting lineups as it is, it's a pretty young team. Ryan Quinn, a fullback who's a sophomore. Logan Quinn, a junior running back. Manny Bozeski, he's a junior as well. And then you look at this line. You see a lot of experience on the line, at least, of the 5 starters on the offensive line. You have 1 senior in Jamie Brown, and then Will Hollenbeck, Sebastian Perez, John Stevens, and Keegan Sheridan, all juniors. In comparison, on Worcester Tech's side, they bring 43 players to road games. They've got 12 seniors, 22 juniors, and 9 sophomores available to them. As now the Bulldogs will take the field here on homecoming, and a tremendous crowd having come to Bulldog Field for this one. It's also the last scheduled home game of the 8-game regular season for the Bulldogs. Imagine senior night as well, as the purple and gold take to the field, looking for their second victory of the season, led by 6th-year head coach Anthony Cicino, son of Dave Cicino, who was the first head coach at Fitchburg State way back in the day. See the captains coming out to the field. Jamie Brown, Logan Quinn, and Mason Burke are the captains for Monty Tech. And we'll throw it over to public address announcer Jake Kelly with the rest of the starting lineups, well, the rest of the festivities and all that. It's Monty Tech football here on FATV. So as you see, Monty Tech wins the toss and will receive to start the contest. This looks to be an exciting game. And the Red Raiders on the road at Westboro this week. As I mentioned before, we haven't been to Monty Tech in quite a while. I know my very first game for FATV back in 2010 was right here at Bulldog Field at Monty Tech. So a little bit of full circle for me, but we're looking forward to an exciting contest. So as we'll continue on with the festivities, we'll have the national anthem sung by Sam Burek.
Tonight's anthem is being performed by Monty Tech Junior and CAD Drafting and Design student Samuel Burek.
Tremendous anthem sung by Sam Burek and a tremendous crowd here at the Fitchburg-Westminster line for week six of the 2021 MIAA football season. Daniel Bolak here with you on FATV. You see Worcester Tech, the Eagles in the road, white uniforms, white shirts, white pants, silver helmets. They'll go left to right in the first quarter of play. Monty Tech in the road, purple uniforms, purple pants, white helmets, and gold trim. They'll go right to left in this contest, at least for the first quarter of play. All the way back there to return it is Brady Burpee. As Ernest May kicks it off from the 40-yard line, a line drive, making a beeline to the end zone, and it's going to die right at the goal line, but just barely cross over for a touchback. I had to get Brady Burpee sweating a little bit out there. If it died just at the 1 yard line, it would have been a live ball. He would have had to pick that up, and he would have been in a bad, bad place. But a tremendous kickoff there. So they'll bring the ball to the 20-yard line for first and 10. Slight motion to the right. So you got the handoff up the middle. And a gain of a couple on first down for the Bulldogs. Handoff going to Ryan Quinn. Again, Pat Hall, the quarterback, sophomore to sophomore, basically. A gain of three by the Bulldogs on first down. And we have whistles and our first penalty of the game coming. Got the verdict from our referee tonight. It's actually a sideline infraction. So a warning issued to Monty Tech. On second down, run up on the far side. A bit of space there for the Bulldogs. And wrestle out of bounds just past the 40-yard line. Pat Hall calling his own number. He gets a good chunk of yardage, about 20 yards for a first down. Just makes his way out to the flank, out to the far side. And tremendous pursuit there. Gabe Thorne ultimately taking him out of bounds. A fresh set of downs for the Bulldogs as everyone trying to get ready out there. If there's something they want to check out there on the far side. Some personnel crossing the field to the far side to the Worcester Tech end. Went on first down, trying to twist his way through the middle. Gets himself a few yards. It's another 3 yard gain for Quinn on first down. Brings it to about the 46 yard line. Check that, about the 43. Second down, trying to burst right up the middle, but three Eagles there to wrap up Quinn. Nothing much there on second down. Actually back him up 2 yards. Didn't even get forward progress, just great, great defense there by the Eagles. Jan Walls. Nasamike, also there for the Eagles. As Hill throws out near side, it's gonna be caught at the left flank. Bulldogs making their way up the field and pushed out of bounds. Inside the Eagle 30-yard line. Logan Quinn with the reception and the big gain for the purple and gold. To the 30-yard line on that one, a gain of 29 yards. Bulldogs making their way. Now Ryan Quinn out to the right side. Found a bit of space there to work with. 5 yards he'll gain as Walls takes him down. And a penalty coming in at the very end of that. Hold against the Bulldogs, 10 yards from the spot. As I came so close to the end of the play, most of those yards will count. We'll spot it right on the 37-yard line. So you'll give 3 yards for it to Quinn. Running around to the left side, getting airborne as he's taken out of bounds by three Eagles. Pat Hall again calling his own number, not afraid to run with the football at all. Strong gain on the first and about 13. Spot him at the 23. Gain of 14 yards for the quarterback.
Let's go, Aiden.
With the delayed handoff, tries to make his way to the right side, trying to get to the marker right on the 20-yard line. He's only going to be able to get back to the line of scrimmage this time around. Brings up another third down for the purple and gold. You can see Walls again, came to this game with 13 tackles, the senior wide receiver and linebacker for the Eagles. He's been a hungry defender just about everywhere for the blue and white. All rolling out, throws incomplete, just a bit too high out of the reach of Logan Quinn. Obviously the Bulldogs in four down territory have not attempted an extra point this season. I have no idea even who their kicker is at this time. One of those questions that slipped my mind when asking the coaches. Got to get to the 24, first down. 7:51 to go in the first quarter of play. It's on fourth down. All throw over the middle, intercepted. It's Walls again for the Eagles. Trying to bring that one back quite a distance. He's still going. And he's not going to be stopped. There is a flag out there. He's into the end zone for a provisional touchdown. They often say on fourth down, you should just knock the ball down because you don't want to take the risk of losing yardage on an interception. John Valls able to bring that back quite a distance. We're going to see how much of it will actually count because of the infraction. All eyes on our referee. Personal foul that was indicated. That will back up the yardage. They will give Walls to the 37-yard line and then march it back. That's what it appears. So we'll give to the 25. So we'll see what the Eagles can do on first down. Nothing going for Worcester Tech. Charles Manu Jr., the junior running back, 828 yards on the campaign, 12 touchdowns in the run game. Stuffed on first down. Ultimately, they'll give him maybe a yard. Not a whole lot going there on that first down play. Second down and around. There's Balls. We already saw his wheels. Wasn't able to use them that effectively that time. Couldn't get to the flank. The Bulldogs beat him there. It's a loss of a few. Just a lot of Bulldogs getting over there. Jamie Brown and Ethan Chaput, two of the Bulldogs getting there. It's Fleming throwing over the middle, incomplete. Juan and Manu there. Had a chance to say Keenan Fleming's name, the junior quarterback. His pass over the middle for Manu, incomplete. Bulldogs on their first drive on defense force a three and out after making some good progress downfield. Fleming, the quarterback, to punt it away. High in the air, and that didn't go terribly far. It's not what the Eagles were hoping for. It's going to be about 15 yards the most. It'll be tremendous field position for Monty Tech, basically back to where they started. It'll go in the books as a 14-yard punt. Tech do on their second drive of the contest on first down. Wheels churning on the run up the middle. Back to Ryan Quinn it goes. Get a healthy number of yards on first down. Just past the halfway point of the first quarter of play. No score between these two Worcester County Tech School foes. Second down, five to go. Saul calling out signals out of the pistol. Put a man in motion to set up the block for Quinn. Tries to plow his way up the middle. He got himself pretty close to what he needed for the first. Say that's good enough. Stop the clock, move the chains. First down for the Bulldogs. So the 27-yard line. See, they've got those tight ends set up to try to help with the blocking that time. First down, run up the middle. Vanasa Namike reading that well. 32 tackles for the junior defensive end. Add another to his account. No gain for the Bulldogs on first down. Second and 10. Another handoff, we're gonna go to Logan this time. Slight improvement on that one, but not much compared to the last play. So the last one was a 1 yard gain, this one another one for about a yard or so. To 26 it goes. Number 14, Logan wearing number 28. The higher number is the older one. Hall's gonna keep it himself. Found some space to work with. Hit from below and above. Wrapped up originally by Namike and then Gabe Thorne coming in for the finisher. Hall gains a couple of yards and brings up another fourth down.
Go for it!
Bulldogs very much in four down territory again. We saw them throw on fourth down last time, led to an interception. They pitch out to Ryan Quinn, finds a lot of space on the right side. He's got a first down. He's inside the 15-yard line. The Dow close to the 10. Might have been selling out on the pass that time. Nifty hand movement there by the quarterback Hall. Leaves it for Ryan Quinn, who finds lots of space to work with on that far side. He's able to construct a first down out of it. Under 2.5 to go in the first quarter. Play no score. Bulldogs lurking downfield, 11 yards from goal. Ball's going to keep himself, try to find his way around the left side, but breaking through the line and breaching the defense was Curtis Morris. Senior defense lineman for the Eagles. Blows that one up at the line of scrimmage. Well managed by the Eagles. Worcester Tech coming into this game 4-1. Monty Tech 1-4. But the Bulldogs have looked the better team in this first quarter of play. Second down, Ryan Quinn left side, trying to burst through towards the goal line. If he doesn't have the touchdown, and he doesn't have the touchdown, but he looks like he's got enough for a fresh set of downs. Down at the 1 yard line. The Bulldogs are going to have 4 shots at a touchdown here. Looking for the opening score.
Let's go, offense! Go! Let's go!
So it's Hall trying to push it up the middle, but before he got started, false start indicated against Monty Tech. Didn't like the motion there. Back him up to the 6. It's not going to be just a case of shoving it up the middle 4 times. Looks like if there hadn't been a penalty, Hall probably would have gotten in there, but then again, the false start probably helps in that regard. Ryan Quinn trying to get around the right side of the tackles. Rolled up there around the 3. Get about half the distance he needs. So second and goal again for the Bulldogs. 3 more shots to find pay dirt. Ball's going to keep himself. He's got some space. Hurdles into the end zone. Touchdown, Bulldogs! Finishes off the drive and gets the home side on the board. On that drive, Monty Tech just kept it on the ground. That's been so effective for them on these drives. That first drive, they were able to march downfield, make the run game work. They were able to get a couple decent passes off. But, you know, after that interception this time, all running, all in the Quins. And this time, Hall found the opening, well manufactured by the offensive line. 2-point conversion, good. 8-0 Bulldogs. And a half to go in the first quarter of play, 8-0. We see Monty Tech in front here on homecoming. Want to remind you, all FATV remote productions underwritten by Workers Credit Union, Rollstone Bank and Trust, UMass Memorial Health Alliance, Clinton Hospital, North End Subaru, Unitil, Minuteman Press, and the Sentinel and Enterprise. We thank them for all of their assistance. An electric atmosphere here at the Fitchburg-Westminster line. We're on the Westminster side of it, of course, as all the athletic facilities except for the old gym at Monty Tech are. I'm happy to be with you here tonight. As the Bulldogs get the first strike on homecoming. We now learn Mason Burke, senior wide receiver from Ashburnham, is going to do kicking duties for the Bulldogs. We've been mostly seeing the Monty Tech offense on the field, as Worcester Tech, their one drive was a 3 and out. They'll look for improvement. A line drive bounced at the 25 or so. Picked up there on the near side. Bring it close to the 40-yard line is Fabian Pignon, the senior receiver for the Eagles. So from the 39-yard line is where the Eagles will start their second drive of the contest with 34.9 on the clock. So great defense by Monty Tech on the first drive. Up the middle on first down, nothing doing there. Charles Manu well equalized. As he gets about a yard or two on forward progress and nothing more than that. Under 10 seconds to go in the frame. Eagles are interested in running another play. Keegan Fleming from under center, hands it off to Manu. Finding a lot more room to work with up the middle. Got him going to get himself close to the line to gain. Definitely the most effective play for the Eagles, but it's only their fifth offensive play of the contest. And that's all the time they've had in the first quarter of play. As through 12 minutes of play, it's Monty Tech 8 and Worcester Tech nothing. While we have a moment, we want to remind you that Fitchburg Access Television is your local access television station. If you live, work, go to school, or are a member of a Fitchburg organization, you can become a member of FATV. Membership brings you many benefits and gives you access to all of FATV's equipment, including cameras, audio, and lighting equipment, editing suites, studios, and much more, including the newest addition, the FATV Podcast Suite. We offer technical training classes to teach you how to create your own program, and you can reserve channel time to broadcast your program to the community and beyond. Visit FATV.org for more details and start producing your own show today. So one quarter complete from Bulldog Field in Westminster. 8-0 Monty Tech in front. Gotta get the chains turned around the right way now that the players are lined up where they need to be. As soon as they get those chains rectified. See the gentleman in crutches there is head coach Derek Robbins. Sustained an injury a little over a month ago, but has been fighting through it on the sidelines. Third year head coach for the Eagles, 6-5 record in his first campaign. Looks like Fleming trying to do the sneak, just taking it himself. He's obviously going to get the first down as the maul is formed. Getting the ball across midfield into Bulldogs territory. So first down for Worcester Tech. They'll spot at the 46-yard line. From my count, I've got Monty Tech with well over 100 yards of offense in this contest. Worcester Tech hasn't had a chance to do a whole lot on first down, trying to make their way to the flank on the far side. Progress not there. Ernest May, senior fullback, as we mentioned, also the kicker, trying to make his way out there, but well pursued. We see Jamie Brown and Ethan Chaput again on the coverage for the Bulldogs. Shutting that opportunity down, stopping May at the line of scrimmage. Nothing gained there on first down. This one a run up the middle. A lot of moonlight to work with for the Eagles. It's Charles Manu Jr. to the end zone. And just like that, Worcester Tech's on the board. 13th touchdown of the season for white number five. You give him that much space to work with and he'll run all day. Charles Manu Jr., who is fittingly enough a junior, makes it 8-6, they'll go for two. Fleming rolling to the right side, gonna try to keep it himself. He's gonna get in there. 2-point conversion is good. And we're level at 8. .955 to go in the second quarter of play. We're knotted up at 8. Look at the conversion again. Fleming was looking like he wanted to pass it there, but he saw the opening to work with on the right side. Why not take advantage? And the junior play caller put two on the board, his first 2-point conversion this season. Crazy Eights in Westminster. Drive kick from May. They hauled in at the 15-yard line. And Burke finding some space to work with, trying to walk the tightrope. He stays in bounds. He makes his way to the far side of the field right now. Still looking for more space. Ran a very long distance to get some more yards. It'll take it inside the Eagle 40-yard line. He gets to the sideline, able to walk the tightrope, very close to stepping out. He stays in bounds. You know, he's just trying to run to the far side, try to outrun Gabe Thorin. Couldn't do it, but makes his way to the 39-yard line. That's great field position for Monty Tech to start this drive with 9:42 to go in the second quarter of play. First down, handoff, Ryan Quinn out to the right side, trying to elude the grasp of John Valls. But Valls able to wrap him up. And nothing gained for Ryan Quinn on first down. Another second down, 10 to go. If my counting is right, Quinn's got 76 yards on the ground already in this contest for the purple and gold. As Hall looks to throw, floated up there, and overthrown is what that one was. Wanted to find Aiden LeBlanc. LeBlanc, a freshman running back. Bulldogs not afraid to go deep into the depth there. But just a little too much air on that pass. Third and 10. You pitch out, but right as Ryan Quinn gets the ball, flag. And the initial signal is against Worcester Tech. So the offside will make it a little easier for the Bulldogs. A free five. So to the 34-yard line will go. Monty Tech happily taking the free yards. 1 for 3 on third down tonight are the Bulldogs. And Hall will keep it himself. Makes his way to the left side, changing directions as best he could, try to find a little more space. They'll make it back to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. That brings up fourth down. Looks like it was his counterpart on defense, Keegan Fleming, making the tackle. Right now on the three plays, the only yards conceded on this drive by Worcester Tech are the 5 yards conceded by penalty. Bulldogs will go for it on fourth down. Hall throws right side, incomplete. Trying to find Logan Quinn, but out of his reach it was. Worcester Tech will have the ball with 7:51 to go in the first half play. Can't fault the idea of going for it on, let's see, on fourth down. We've only seen one punt in this contest, and it wasn't a very good one. And for Monty Tech, you look at them coming into today, they are 1-4, looking to try to spark something on first down. Manu gets himself a few more yards. Looks like the engine started to warm up there for him.
Everybody got their hands.
It's about 6 on first down. To the 40-yard line he gets. It'll be a pitch out and a run near side. Manu trying to turn the corner. He's going to turn the corner. Nice juke there as he makes his way now parallel to the 45-yard line. Still on his feet. Still making his way downfield. And he's tripped up by Mason Burke inside the 10-yard line. A tremendous run from Charles Manu Jr. A 50-plus yard run, and he needed to run way more than 50 yards to get all those. So he basically has to run from one side of the field to the other. But tremendous endurance for the young man. Gets it to the 6-yard line. And Vaughn loses the football! A tremendous break for Monty Tech. They give it to John Balls. Tries to run up the middle, lost a handle on the football, and it's recovered in the end zone for a touchback. Just lost the handle on it as he was going to ground, and it's recovered by Ethan Chaput. Sophomore guard and linebacker from Holden. It's been darn near everywhere on defense for Monty Tech. And Worcester Tech, stunned from that development, calls their first timeout. 6:39 to go, first half. It's 8-8 the score. Take a moment to thank our crew working this game here from the Fitchburg Westminster line. Nate Glenny is our director today. Travis Falk, audio, graphics, technical support, all the good stuff. Robin Como on replay. Kevin Newey and Jared Roberts are up on top of the press box providing the high camera angles. And then we've got a bunch of Monty Tech students here tonight providing the cameras down low. Chris Abando, Lucas Gunderman, May Marion, and Sam Birak all rotating through on camera. You may have heard I said Sam Birak's name before. Yes, he went from the national anthem to working camera for us tonight. And we thank everyone for all the help here today. Try to bring you a great broadcast here from Bulldog Field. Of course, next week we'll be back in action from historic Crocker Field. Fitchburg Red Raiders playing host to the Neshoba Wolves. That'll be a 7 o'clock start. We'll join us for that as well. Monty Tech will be on the road next week. They'll be taking on Assabet. 7 o'clock start from Fitchburg Street in Marlboro. And then they finish their regular season down in Worcester, taking on Abby Kelly Foster. That'll be on Friday the 29th. For Worcester Tech, they'll be at Keefe Tech next week, hosting Keefe Tech next week, and then at Bay Path. Pitch out to the right on first down, Ryan Quinn. Get some space down there. A gain of about 7, but then a flag at the very end after the tackle by Lamike. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Worcester Tech. It's a free 15 yards that the Bulldogs will happily take. Bring the ball to the 41-yard line. Penalties for 30 yards against Worcester Tech in this contest. So on first down, it's Logan Quinn up the right side, dragged down mostly by the jersey, but not before a gain of about 5. Gets it to the 46. Replay, you can see Monty Tech tries to make their way with lots of deception in the backfield, make it challenging for the defense to track. Second and 5. It's going to be Logan Quinn taking it on the end around, essentially. Stiff arms a man and gets a couple extra yards out of it. For the flying tackle coming in there from Worcester Tech in the form of Andrew Amor Mensa. Ultimately, it feels like one of those plays that probably got more, didn't get as much as you thought they were on that one, only about a gain of 1. So the 47 brings up 3rd and 4. Get, put the ball cleanly in Worcester State territory to get a first down. Ryan Quinn's going to try to do just that. I think he's got there. Let's stop the clock and move the chains. He did very much get there. And a first down for the Bulldogs. Spot it right at the 48-yard line in Eagle territory. Under 5 to go in the first half of play. Monty Tech 8, Worcester Tech 8. Quinn's going to keep it himself on the option, making his way to the far side. Gets wrapped up by Jan Balls. Able to break out of the hold from the Bulldog. Ball's able to hold him to just about 2 yards. Four minutes to go, first half of play, 8-8 the score, and 2nd and 8 coming. Calling out the audibles, trying to see if he can get Worcester Tech to jump. They've done it once before in this contest. Quinn to the right side, broke out of 2 tackles, out of a 3rd! Tremendous movement there by the sophomore running back. Gets into the 40-yard line. Does get the first down out of it. Got a little more than even that. And look at that, 3 tackles he was able to break out of. And it takes 2 more to take him down there in Amor Mensa and Steve Atoke. Lots of misdirection on first down from the 37-yard line. It's ultimately Hall running with it. So Bulldogs making their way ever further into Eagles territory, trying to work the clock effectively. See if they can get a score before halftime. Worcester Tech will have the ball to start the second half. Mitek really wants to come away with some points on this drive. Ball's had that well read that time, blows it up in the backfield. It's the most significant loss on the ground that Monty Tech's had tonight. Brings it to about third and 11. 2-5 are the Bulldogs on third down tonight. Blast it right up the middle, try to get as many yards as they can. To the 35, Ryan Quinn again. Gets him to the 35. And brings it fourth down and 8 to go. Ball has struggled a little bit through the air tonight. 1 of 5 with a pick. I think Coach Anthony Cicino is going to take all the play clock that they can off and then call time. Can stop the clock there with a minute 17 to go in the first half of play. 8-8 the score. A reminder that in addition to our live streams on the internet, you can now watch FATV programming in stunning high definition on the following streaming devices: Roku, Fire TV, and Apple TV, or through our apps in the Android and Apple stores. Download our free app today, and to learn more on how to watch FATV programming, go to fatv.org/watch-FATV. That's fatv.org/watch-FATV. Whether you're from Fitchburg, for one of the 18 communities that Monty Tech serves, or even from Worcester, watching the Worcester Tech Eagles play, or from anywhere else in this fine world, we thank you for joining us here tonight, here from Bulldog Field in Westminster. Daniel Bolak here with you from the top row of the bleachers. Just a tremendous sight to see all the fans. It's well packed here at Bulldog Field. Tremendous crowd for homecoming. Fans all along the fences as well here on the near side. A wonderful atmosphere here on homecoming week here in North County. 8-8 the score, 77 seconds to go in the second quarter. Bulldogs need 8 for a fresh set of downs on one play. They've been keeping it mostly on the ground tonight. See if they try to go through the air. I think that's what Worcester Tech's planning on defending. That's what they're going to have to defend. Long ball on the left side. Tipped up in the air. Is that caught? Yes, it is! The home run pass tipped up and caught by Mason Burke. Bulldogs are in business now. Caught at the 10-yard line. And it'll be first and goal. It's up the middle. It's Ryan Quinn keeping it on the ground. Bulldogs have 2 timeouts to use. They'll use their second here on the first down run. 48.1 to go here in the first half of play. The Bulldogs are threatening. Let's have another look at that last play. All hoisting it up there. It was tipped up, and then Burke able to come up with it. You can see Manny Bozeski there also on offense for the Bulldogs. That's one of the two receivers. It was two against two. And that time, Worcester Tech trying to learn their lesson from earlier when they had that interception on fourth down. Try to knock that ball down. You can see Derek Robbins, the third-year head coach, talking to his side. Last week, the Eagles, against a struggling Assabet team, played a much closer game than I think they would have liked. It's a 13-12 win. Worcester Tech came away with it. A blocked extra point ended up being the difference in that contest. Whereas Monty Tech, the offense has struggled at times this season. Of course, they scored 24 against Gardner, but the other game, 6-6-6-0, so this is already their second best effort of the campaign. They've already got one score tonight and looking for a second. About the seven, Hall on the right side. He's got the space, he's got the touchdown. That Hall finds the end zone for the second time today. 41.9 to go in the half. The Bulldogs have the score they wanted, and they've made it a 14-8 game. Great blocking by the O-line, opening up that path to the end zone from 7 yards out. Or make it nine. Whatever number it was, never had a good look at where exactly the ball was, but now we'll see. Monty Tech go for two again. Hall looking to his right, and it couldn't be hauled in there by Logan Quinn. Looked like he was short of the end zone as well. Was gonna be a challenging one. But nevertheless, 14-8. Bulldogs on homecoming with a great showing thus far. Now, if you're Worcester Tech, you do have two timeouts left, I believe. And you're getting the ball to start in the second half. If they get a good enough return to make it worth their while, it might be worth trying to go for it. And you know number five out there for the Bulldogs, and Charles Manu Jr. We've seen him with the wheels, 124 yards on the ground tonight already, mainly on the back of two huge runs. To kick off. Puts a squib on the ground, not even going to consider the idea of kicking it deep. Manu waiting all the way back there. He's already got a kickoff return for a touchdown this season. You don't want to mess around with that. To the 34-yard line, it'll be recovered. 39.2 on the clock. Probably imagine on first down, the thinking's probably going to be hand it to number five, see what he can do. On first down, Fleming actually going to throw instead. Throws to the right side, it's complete inbounds. That's going to burn a timeout. It'd be too obvious if they just gave it to Manu. So the throw to Aiden Smith is complete. And the Eagles will call their second timeout with 31 seconds. Five yards gained on first down. One timeout in the tank. Fleming out of the pistol, low snap, able to pick that up. Have to roll to his left. Gets the ball off and bounces into the grass, incomplete. Bulldogs immediately able to put Fleming under pressure with the less than stellar snap. Mm-hmm. like the intended receiver there would have been in Fabian Pignon. Bring up third and five. Bulldogs looking for a stop. They try to go back to Manu. Manu Jr. did not get enough for the first down. Clock's going to keep running. And a flag comes out at the very end. Wonder what we've got here. It's a substitution infraction against Monty Tech. I did see one of the Bulldogs running off the field as if he was an extra man. Extra man he was, 5 free yards. We'll give them the first down. But obviously Worcester Tech a long way away from the end zone. From the 44-yard line, we'll give it to Manu. Just got to keep the play alive, essentially. Try to keep it going for as long as he can. Bulldogs in try to wrestle him out of bounds, and they will do just that. Get him to step on that sideline to bring an end to the first half of play. We're on homecoming. It's Monty Tech in front of Worcester Tech, 14-8. You came into today looking at the records. Monty Tech coming in 1-4, Worcester Tech 4-1. But this is not played like a game in which those records are what you were expecting. Monty Tech sticking right with Worcester Tech punch for punch, able to manufacture two scoring drives. They've got well over 150 yards of offense in this contest. For Worcester Tech, they've got about 150 yards themselves, mainly thanks to the running of Charles Manu Jr. 7 carries for 140 yards and a touchdown. At this point, I think we're just going to take a break. We'll let you continue to take in the sights and sounds of homecoming here from Monty Tech. And when we come back, we'll have first half stats and analysis. It's Monty Tech football here on FATV.
Thank you.
We're back at Bulldog Field here in Westminster, getting ready for the start of the second half here. Monty Tech football here on FATV, it's homecoming week. And the Bulldogs have a 14-8 lead over the Eagles of Worcester Tech. Daniel Bolak here with you, happy to have you along with us here tonight. Looking at the first half stat summary, Worcester Tech with 11 plays for 140 yards. Monty Tech, 32 plays for 174 yards. They've obviously done the majority of the possession in regards to the football. Some very long clock-killing drives. And for Worcester Tech, they had a three and out. They had a tremendous touchdown run from Charles Manu Jr. Seven carries for 132 yards, what I've got him down for. After, you know, doing the calculations, double-checking everything, which included a very long touchdown run to put the Eagles on the board, and then another one to put him inside the 10, but the ball fumbled away. Monty Tech was able to take the ball, bring it downfield, and get a score out of it. That's obviously what Worcester Tech's going to be focused on, is retorting after the fumble, the return for a touchdown in the end, an 80-yard drive manufactured by Monty Tech. And flags on the kickoff. I suspect Monty Tech will have to kick this one off from... Well, they will have to kick it off from a different spot. And that'll be minus 5 yards against the Bulldogs. They'll have to kick off from the college setup, the 35-yard line. So we'll try it again, put that on the ground. That's going to go out of bounds. So the flags obviously will fly there. And Worcester Tech will have options. They can take the ball from the spot that it goes out of bounds. They can take it 30 yards from the kickoff, or they can make Monty Tech kick it off again from the 30. The referee checking with Coach Robbins. Either have the ball from the 35, they can have it from where it went out. Or they can have Monty Tech kick from the 30. I believe those would be the options. And ultimately they are going to make them kick off from the 30. Amazement in my little scorebook, I have not made anything for kickoff out of bounds. So we'll try again. Third time's the charm from the 30-yard line. Takes a few bounces on the ground. Manu will take it in. Obviously, dangerous man. A dangerous man. Bring it back to that 20, the 10. He breaks it all the way. Touchdown, Eagles. That was what Monty Tech was trying to avoid at all costs, to avoid that ball getting into the hands of Charles Manu Jr. And they couldn't make it happen in the end. On the kickoff from the 30-yard line, he brings it all the way. This could not be stopped, and just like that, Worcester Tech has responded. Tied it up at 14, and this will be absolutely key. Now they do have their kicker in Ernest Bay in the backfield, but it looks like he's lined up to take the ball as a fullback, but Fleming will throw right side, tipped it incomplete. Bay is 7 for 9 on extra points this season, but ultimately they decide to go with the two-point conversion. It's unsuccessful, and it stays 14-14. So that's very much the answer Worcester Tech was looking for. We're expecting him to get the ball into the hands of number five, ultimately on the third try on the kickoff. Charles Manu able to pick it up and bring it all the way back. 14-14 the score. A whole new ball game, 23 minutes and 47 seconds of regulation. Kickoff handled just inside the 20-yard line on the far side. And three Eagles there to meet him. On the run back was Aiden LeBlanc. See what the Bulldogs can do to respond. On first down, Ryan Quinn, right side. Wrestled down at the 30, but a flag coming in at the end. A hold against Monty Tech will back them up. Yards from the spot. Place it right at the 19-yard line. Second, so it'll be first and 20 is what it'll be. Lots want to make sure they've got the play they want. Quarterback. He's found the end zone twice on the ground. And that flag comes from the back judge, which generally will mean delay a game. It's not going to make things easier. Took them a while to get to the line, took them a while to get themselves settled in, and ultimately they took too long for the satisfaction of the officials. To the 14-yard line. That'll make it first and Gardner. Make things a little challenging on this drive. Forces Hall to go to the air on first down. Trying to find Brady Burpee on that air side. He's got him! Seen that before. The idea of take debilitating penalties, then get it all back in one go. First reception of the night for Brady Burpee. Brings it to the 44-yard line. A 30-yard gain through the air. But just like that, all the penalties erased. Fresh set of downs on first, right up the middle. Ryan Quinn going to get to the other side of the 45-yard line, give him the 46. As Gabe Thorne tries to hide the fact that he lost his hat. Came off a bit at the very end there. Looks like he's going to get away with it. Will he? Nope. Ernest May will have to come in to replace him. Second and a short nine it'll be for the Bulldogs. Ball will take it on the option. Find space on the left side. He's got a first down, trying to cut up the middle. Met by a bunch of Eagles. But he's still well into Worcester Tech territory. It'll be another first down for the purple and gold. Given the 41-yard line. As you can see, the defense closing in at the very end, but still, it's a great weapon to have there at quarterback there in Pat Hall, and just a sophomore as well. Really helps make this offense work. First and 10, trying the hard count, see if they can get Worcester Tech to jump. They're not interested, but Ryan Quinn's going to find a gap up the middle to run right through to the 30-yard line. Stop the clock, move the chains, another first down. So go to 8:10 to go in the third quarter of play. 14-14. Bulldogs led 14-8 at halftime. But 80-plus yard kick return by Worcester Tech tied the score. As Hall hands off again. Ryan Quinn wrestled back there. Manas Maniche ended up making the tackle, but he lost his helmet. So out for a play he will go. I know when I was talking with Coach Roberts before the game, we wanted to double check how to say his name, Manas Maniche. And so we called him over to get him to say his name for us. We'll finish that one in a moment as Hall out to the right side. Now a nice cut back in there to get a few extra yards. And it takes pretty much the whole dang team to take him down if they can. The Bulldogs don't play rugby. That was a proper scrum and a maul. Had to take advantage while the iron was hot with Maniche off the field. But as I was saying, Coach Robbins, when he called him over, it's like, this is the gentleman who's going to be saying your name a lot tonight. Want to make sure we got it right. I may have slipped out the wrong syllable once or twice in this contest, but now Anas Maniche back on the field. And the Bulldogs into the red zone at the 20-yard line. On first down, Quinn immediately wrapped up. Wyatt Dancy, 24 tackles coming into today. Able to burst right through, right around the lineman there. Blow that one up for a gain of naught. Approach the halfway point of this third quarter, 14-14. And again, Monty Tech is threatening. Had the ball for so much in this contest. Ryan Quinn again, right side. Dancy was the first to arrive, got a handful of jersey. And a couple extra Eagles coming in for good measure. Back to the line of scrimmage and nothing more than that. And Monty Tech is going to call their first timeout of the second half. 5:40 to go in the third quarter, 14 all the score. Just so you know, there's so much to watch on your community access station. Check out the quality FATV programs like Barbara and You, Inside Fitchburg, Chess Chat, Forks Over Fitchburg, and Discussing Fitchburg Now. FATV also covers many local events, including the Memorial Day ceremony, graduations, and local high school and collegiate sports, like you're watching right now. Watch local government meetings and some of the best local election coverage around. Visit FATV.org for schedules, access video on demand on your time, and view our live streams. Well, we also have another moment. Want to once again thank our underwriters who help make all of our remote productions possible. They are Workers' Credit Union, Rollstone Bank and Trust, UMass Memorial Health, Health Alliance Clinton Hospital, North End Subaru, Unitil, Minuteman Press, and the Sentinel and Enterprise. We thank them for all of their support. On my count, 40 plays, 240 yards for Monty Tech on offense tonight. Worcester Tech 11 for 140. With nearly all of those yards coming in the hands of Charles Manu Jr. For the Bulldogs, Pat Hall's got 73 yards on the ground. Ryan Quinn's got 75 on the ground. And 84 yards through the air for Hall. Big completions, all of them. There's a throw, right side, tipped up in the air and incomplete. It's Keenan Fleming had the coverage for the blue and white. Manny Bozeski, the junior from Winchendon, was the intended receiver. But great coverage there by the Eagle quarterback, playing as the safety. Yes, when the Bulldogs do hit those passes, they've been big ones. 29, 30, and 25 yards they've all gone for. And on fourth down, it's Hall on the option, trying to get as many yards as he can out to the left side. It's not gonna be enough for a first down, but at the very least, it will put Worcester deep in their own territory to start this next drive with 5:25 to go in the third quarter of play, 14-14. So it'll be 85 yards to goal for Worcester Tech in a 14-14 game. And the junior play caller, Keenan Fleming, stepping up to the line. They give it to Charles Manu Jr. And he's tripped up just past the 25-yard line, close to the 30. Could have been more disaster for the Bulldogs had it not been for that. Lost his shoe on all that, too. Manu cutting to his right, finding a path there. Tripped up is what stops his progress. A gain of 16 yards. Another first down, right up the middle will go again for Manu. Bring him to about the 38-yard line. Another good gain for the junior running back. Now lots of stuff happening there, nothing good for Worcester Tech on that one. They try to give it back to Manu as I was looking down at the worst time. Third and down upcoming for the Eagles. So Manu just tripped up in the backfield is what ended up happening. As he tries to cut to the right. Probably a loss of about a yard. Third and about five. 154 yards on the night for Manu. Pitch out on the right side for May. Change of pace needed there to give Manu a break. And Ernest May forced out of bounds. 1 yard past the marker to gain. That'll refresh the box. And the Eagles get a first down. May again. Starting to burst through the right side of the line. Diving forward for a gain of about 4 or 5. Give him the 48 on that one. May with 3 carries for 11 yards in the contest. We take under 3 to go in the third quarter. Another run up the middle there for Manu. Charles Manu Jr. approaching 1,000 yards on the season for Worcester Tech. Add another 5 to his ledger, and that'll give him a first down. Worcester Tech's already run 6 plays on this drive. They only had 11 offensive plays from my count in the first half. Shows to the efficiency they've had. Manu wants that left side. He wants the flank. And he's got a lot of room to run inside the 30-yard line. He goes. Another first down for Worcester Tech. To the 28-yard line, a 19-yard gain. And another first down for Worcester Tech. Ultimately, wanted to try to figure out how he was going to get around Mason Burke and friends. But the moment to deliberate caused him to get wrapped up. Eagles keeping it on the ground. They go to May this time. He'll bring it inside the 20-yard line, now into the red zone. Interesting thing is, Worcester Tech's not had a successful drive in the red zone tonight. Their first touchdown came from a very long touchdown run from Manu, and their second was on a kick return from Manu. When they had a sustained drive at the 6-yard line, they fumbled it away. Fleming to hand it off. Manu again, right side, just running parallel. He's gonna be wrestled down close to the line to gain. If it's third down, it's going to be third and short. Bring it third and 1. Manu just trying to get all the way out there. But Bozeski able to wrap him up. Sneak on this one, they just need a yard. They'll get plenty for that. Keenan Fleming to get the first. Stop the clock, move the chains. We're under a minute to go in the third quarter. To the 15-yard line. Fleming goes. Crowd watching with bated breath. It's Manu up the middle again. Looks like the Bulldogs will stop him after a gain of about 4. Give him 1 more to put it right at the 10. A lot of plays on this drive for Worcester Tech. This will be the 12th play of the drive. They're going to have to score on the other end zone as we've reached three-quarter time at Bulldog Field. Worcester Tech retorting as quickly as possible with a kickoff return for a touchdown to level the score. And at three-quarter time, it's Monty Tech 14, Worcester Tech 14. You see the tremendous crowd here at Bulldog Field, packing the stands here on homecoming, and me up in the corner. Again, want to thank our wonderful crew helping make this broadcast possible. Nate Glennie is directing, Travis Falk audio, graphics, technical support, Robin Como on replay, Kevin Newey and Jared Roberts up on the roof of the press box. Chris Obando, Lucas Gunderman, May Marion, and Sam Birak, our camera operators down on the field tonight. Our field camera operators, all Monty Tech students, happy to have them on board for tonight. And also thanks to Bill Gonzalez and David Reed for helping put this together on the Monty Tech side. We haven't been here in quite a long time. I mean, the last time I was at Bulldog Field was the first game I ever did for FATV back in 2010. It's been a long time, 11 years. We may have made a trip or two since. But great to be calling a game here on homecoming. And the folks know the words as Keenan Fleming takes the quarterback sneak on first down. Getting himself a few more yards. Bring it to third and about one. Interesting play call on second and five. Felt they could take advantage of maybe a weakness in the Bulldog D-line. But Fleming gets the play call as he bring it to the huddle. Worcester Tech's called more plays on this drive than they did in the entire first half. Basically taking a page out of Monty Tech's playbook and how they are operating. A long, grinding drive. Jan Valls with the carry on that one. I think that's his first carry since the fumble earlier on in the contest. Only needed 1 yard. He's going to get that. Gain of about two. No more first downs on this drive for Worcester Tech. Four shots at the end zone. 3 yards from goal. Looking to take the lead here. It'd be their first of the night. First and goal from the 3 yard line. Fleming trying to sneak it up the middle. And he's gotten in! Touchdown Eagles! From 3 yards out, Keenan Fleming, the junior quarterback, has his third touchdown on the ground this season. And the Eagles take their first lead of the night with 10:26 to go. As they're gonna go for the conventional extra point here. Ernest Bay is 7 for 9 on the campaign. Kick is up and it is good. Makes overtime an unlikely prospect with 10:26 to go in the fourth quarter. 21-14, Worcester Tech in front. So both teams with long drives to start this second half of play after we saw that kickoff return for a touchdown from Charles Manu Jr. Bulldogs, they're in this one. They've been in this one. Pat Hall and the Quins, Ryan and Logan, have been able to make the offense work. Now they're going to have to go and manufacture another drive. They've got 10 and a half minutes or so to work with. Trailing by 7. A bullet of a kick. That'll make its way to the end zone. That'll be a touchback. So bring it to the 20. It's Clock reads 10:26 to go. In this contest, 21-14, Worcester Tech in front. .245 yards of offense for Monty Tech tonight. Now 262 yards of offense for Worcester Tech. 185 on the ground from Charles Manu Jr. Ryan Quinn on first down. Bit of a blocking convoy on the far side. Brady Burpee leading that. Gets a nice chunk on first and 10. I think if this Monty Tech side a couple of years ago in 2019, they had 8 wins. They won their first MIAA playoff game in program history. Obviously, a very young squad this season, but they have persevered in this contest. A tremendous bounce back after last week, falling 49-0 to Blackstone Valley Tech. This week, a far more competitive affair. First down for Ryan Quinn on that run up the gut. As we've mentioned, a lot of experience for Monty Tech comes on that offensive line, all upperclassmen. Or as some of those skill players, as you'd call them, and Pat Hall, a sophomore, a whistle here. And a false start indicated against the Bulldogs. They'll keep the first down, but it undoes that last run from Quinn. Bring it to a first and 15. We'll wind the clock, 9 minutes to go in regulation time. Bulldogs chasing 7. And on the handoff, Quinn found a hole up the middle. Gets himself right to the 40-yard line, a gain of 11. A lot of the names we've called tonight on offense, none of them seniors for the most part. Just a lot of young players in this Monty Tech side, 20 freshmen, 19 sophomores, 15 juniors, and 8 seniors. Mason Burke, basically the most experienced, he's basically the one senior who's in those skill positions. As Quinn bounces off a tackle, makes his way past the 45-yard line. Give him a first down. Carries for 105 yards. A tremendous presence in the backfield for the Bulldogs. Give him the 46-yard line, 54 yards from goal. We reach 7:45 to go in regulation. That time Quinn trying to make his way to the right side. Hear the cheers from the Worcester Tech side. Tremendously happy with the stoppage there. 2 yards and nothing more than that. The way these two teams have been playing, the goal is definitely to limit mistakes here in this fourth quarter. So Monty Tech can't do something with this drive. They might not get the ball back. Hall on the option, tipped up and incomplete. Getting a hand on that one to disrupt everything was Aiden Smith, and Logan Quinn couldn't haul it in. Third and 8 it'll be. For my count, Monty Tech is 2 for 7 on third down. 6:59 to go, fourth quarter. Monty Tech 14, Worcester Tech 21. Yards required to get a first down. All calling out the signals. He'll keep it himself on the option. Has some space to work with, but just has to try to get there. Ultimately cuts inside. And lots of whistles afterwards. I think because the ball came out at the very end. They'll give him two. About the 49-yard line. And Monty Tech will call their second timeout. Only about a yard gained on that one. The Bulldogs have to get to the 44-yard line of Worcester Tech to get a first down. We have not seen Monty Tech punt tonight. We've only seen a single punt in this contest. That was off the foot of Keegan Fleming, and it was the type of punt that makes you say, yeah, let's not punt. Haven't seen it since. I would say if you have a punter who can put the ball inside the 15-yard line, who can cough and corner it, keep it away from Charles Manu Jr., then it might not be the worst thing to do there if you can trust your defense to get a stop. But I can absolutely see the idea of going for it here on 4th and 7 with the ball on your own side of the field. You're chasing 7, as I mentioned, with how well Worcester Tech did holding on to the ball in the last drive. There's no guarantee you're going to get the ball back if you lose it. See what the Bulldogs have on 4th and about 7. All dropping back. They go for the pass. Right side. Caught by Logan Quinn. It's the shortest completion of the night, but no less significant for the Bulldogs. They'll get the chains moving. Just a dart to the right side, and Logan Quinn hauls in his second catch of the night. 3 catches for 40 yards for the junior running back from Lunenburg. Up the middle they go on first down. Strong gain for Ryan Quinn. Gets half the yards he needs inside the 35-yard line. The 28 carries for 113 yards for the sophomore running back from Lunenburg. Came in the game with 1 touchdown on the season, still has just the one. Oh, that's a botched snap! It popped out of the hands of Pat Hall, but Ryan Quinn able to jump on top of that and limit the damage. Could have been disaster in 12 tenths. It'll be a loss of a yard. As we approach 5 minutes to go in the contest, 3rd and 6, play action. Quinn's got it on the near side. Inside the 30-yard line, it forced out of bounds there. Oh, it's very close to a first down. They come down to the spot. He's got the first down. Got just what he needed. Every completion out of the hands of Pat Hall has been clutch, basically. And there's Hall up the middle, inside the 25-yard line. Give him another five. Seven for 11, 102 yards and a pick for Hall through the air. 16 carries for 84 yards and two touchdowns on the ground. A tremendous force to be reckoned with, the sophomore from Fitchburg. Dynamic quarterback for the purple and gold. Logan Quinn got the handoff that time, but blew a tire on the 25. And loses a foot or two. Bulldogs continue to manufacture this long drive. They started this drive with 10:26 to go in the fourth quarter. We're now at 3:40 to go. Another long clock draining drive. Hall on the option. Finds space on the left side. Inside the 20 he goes. Pretty close to the marker again. Again, it'll be down to the measurement. That'll be good enough yet again. Another first down for the Bulldogs. Go under 200 seconds to go in the game. 21-14. Worcester Tech in front. From the 18-yard line, Brian Quinn trying to find his way on the right side but loses a yard or so to the 20. Time was just a bit of hesitation on the handoff. And that was just enough to get the Worcester Tech defense to converge. Caused the loss of yardage. 20 yards to go for Monty Tech. Under 2.5 to go. 21-14, Worcester Tech in front. Pat Hall with time. Over the middle. Almost intercepted. In and out of the hands, basically, of Keegan Fleming. He had his mitts on it. He just could not keep control of it as he went to the ground. As he was tackled there by Manny Pazeski. That's who Hall wanted there. Well read. Thing on these drives is it feels like the second down play hasn't really done a whole lot for Monty Tech. It's like between first and second down, one of those plays on each set of downs just hasn't been much, but Hall gonna go for it all. Left side, battling with Burke, but incomplete. One-on-one coverage with Gabriel Pignon. Coverage was clean, both players going for the ball. Just Pignon just reading the ball and knocking it away. And on this drive that has spanned more than 8 minutes, a fourth and 12, Monty Tech must find a first down. Hall over the middle, tipped, battled for, it is intercepted in the end. Jan Valls comes up with it with the pick, the second of the day. But on fourth down, not the best time for it. For my count, Monty Tech only has one timeout. But if they can get three stops, It's not going to leave them much time. .159 to go. First priority is they've got to get three stops. That's not going to help matters. As Manu was taken down at the 3-yard line, but I think they might call the late hit. Personal foul marches off 15 yards. But the worst part is the clock runs on it. On first down. Great run up the middle, and really, Monty Tech all just trying to strip the ball away because that's their only shot. But Manu gets another tremendous chunk of yardage on that one to the 33-yard line. Bulldogs call their final timeout. I'm not sure the clock is going to be enough in their favor to get the ball back. Looks like Worcester Tech's done what they've needed to do. 91 seconds left. It's been a great crowd here at homecoming. And the Bulldogs right in it to the very end. So happy to bring you all the sights and sounds here from Bulldog Field on homecoming. As this Bulldog side, 1-4 coming in, putting up a tremendous fight. 310 yards of offense in this contest. But the Eagles take to the field in victory formation. They'll still try to charge the line as best they can. But Monty Tech doesn't have any more timeouts. And the math tells you that it's not going to happen. So second and 11. 60 seconds left. Watch for the back judge to put his hand up to indicate 10 seconds. Brings it down to 5 seconds. We'll take the knee. We'll have to kneel it down one more time. But it's only third down here. But one sour thing for Worcester Tech from a power ratings perspective, a 7-point win isn't going to get them the maximum number of points that they would have wanted to take away from this one, but they'll happily take the victory as it goes. One final kneel down for Worcester Tech as they come from behind to take this one by a score of 21-14. Charles Manu Jr., the hero of the day. 16 carries, 198 yards, one rushing touchdown. Plus he added that kick return touchdown to set the tone here in the second half. There weren't very many drives in this contest. There was only one punt. Just two really long drives for Monty Tech in this second half. Worcester Tech had one long drive that ended in a touchdown, plus the kick return. As I said, if they lost the ball, they weren't going to get it back. They had to score on that last drive. They would have needed the touchdown and the two. But still, credit to Monty Tech, though, for staying in it this whole way, giving quite a heck of a game on homecoming. And we got a chance to see a lot of the potential in this Bulldog side. As we mentioned, a lot of these players still pretty young. Brady Burpee, a sophomore. Pat Hall, a sophomore. Ryan Quinn, a sophomore. Logan Quinn, a junior. Manny Piseski, a junior. You look at that line. Jamie Brown, the lone senior on it. And Mason Burke, a senior as well. Eight seniors on this Monty Tech roster. Still a very young side. So even though they fall to 1-5, we got to see a lot of the potential in them, and they stuck right in it to the very end. I know Derek Robbins of Worcester Tech was telling me their game against Blackstone Valley Tech a couple weeks ago. It was 21-7 was the final, but 14-7 until BVT got a touchdown at the very end, essentially, to get them those maximum points. And Worcester Tech ultimately battling back Charles Manu Jr. A tremendous game for the junior running back. He's now over 1,000 yards this season across six games. He finishes with 16 carries for 198 yards, as we mentioned. Pat Hall, 7 for 14, 102 yards. 17 carries for 90 yards and two touchdowns. A dynamic play caller, and the Bulldogs will have him for another 2 years. Ryan Quinn will have him for another 2 years as well. 29 carries for 111 yards. Logan Quinn with four catches for 47 yards. Burpee, a catch for 30. Burke, a catch for 25. And a tremendous effort from the Bulldogs. Even if they couldn't come away from the victory, there are still good things to take away from this contest. Next up for these two teams, Monty Tech will be traveling to Marlboro to take on the Aztecs of Assabet. That'll be a 7 o'clock start from Fitchburg Street in Marlboro. Meanwhile, Worcester Tech up to 5-1 on the season. They'll be taking on Keith Tech, who have had some struggles this season. The Broncos 0-3. Just the fact that they've only played three games coming into week six tells you they've had some challenges. But Worcester Tech will be looking to try to take another win. And Derek Robbins told me too, the way that the power ratings are, the way they are ranked in it, they basically have to win out to find themselves a spot in the Division 5 playoffs. The victory will help, at least for tonight. Hopefully a little bit. 21-14, Worcester Tech a winner over Monty Tech. Once again, we want to thank our underwriters who help make all of our remote productions possible. Workers Credit Union, Rollstone Bank and Trust, UMass Memorial Health, Health Alliance, Clinton Hospital, North End Subaru, Unitil, Minuteman Press, and the Sentinel and Enterprise. We thank them for all the support they give us. And once again, want to thank our wonderful crew who helped make this broadcast possible. Nate Glennie was directing, Travis Falk on audio and graphics and all the other good stuff. Robin Como on replay, Kevin Newey, Jared Roberts up above the press box, Chris Obando, Lucas Gunderman, May Marion, and Sam Burak, all on the cameras at field level. Tremendous job by the Monty Tech students. Once again, our thanks to Bill Consalvis and Athletic Director Dave Reed for helping us with the logistics and the coordination to make this broadcast possible as well. Like I said, hadn't been to my old alma mater here as a proud Monty Tech alum, class of 2008. Great to be back here. Great to have the chance to call this game. And a tremendous crowd coming out here. One of the best we've seen this year, I've been told. Still to support the team. Even though the Bulldogs fall to 1-5, still a lot of potential. And you know, maybe next year, maybe the year after, they might find themselves back in the thick of the MIAA playoffs. But for now, final score for the final time. It's Monty Tech 14 and Worcester Tech 21. So for everyone here at FATV, I'm Daniel Bolak saying thank you so much for tuning in. And we hope to see you next time. And until then, so long from the Fitchburg-Westminster line.